Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Welcome to Inner World Online Bible Study Saturday. If you are the first time joining our church service, we want you to leave your contact information. We want to know you. If you are not the first time joining our church service, may God bless you. Peace with us all. 亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你们好，欢迎来到真道教会的周六线上敬拜。如果您是第一次参加我们的敬拜，需要将您的联系方式发在对话框里面，我们希望认识您。如果您不是第一次参加我们的敬拜，愿上帝与你同在，平安与我们同在。All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work. God is faithful, by whom you were called into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. 圣经都是由上帝所启示的，有益于教导、督责、矫正和在义上训练人，教属上帝的人得以完全，为行各样的善事而装备。上帝是信实的，他呼召你们好与他儿子我们的主耶稣基督共享团契。 So now please turn on your mic, follow me to read today's scripture catechisms. 接下来呢，请大家把这个麦风打开，跟我一起读一下今天的圣经教理问答。Who is the Redeemer? The only Redeemer is the Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal Son of God.
The eternal Son of God.
In whom God became.
In whom God became.
Man.
And bore the penalty of sin himself. All right, thank you. 谢谢。谁是救赎者？唯一的救赎者是主耶稣基督，上帝永恒儿子，道成肉身，成为人的样式，亲自承担了罪的刑罚。So it's one word we learned last week. We're going to learn again this week. 有一个生词我们上礼拜学习了啊，今天呢我们再重复一遍，叫 redeemer, redeemer,
redeemer.
救赎者，救赎主。Isaiah 48 verse 17. Thus says the Lord, your redeemer.The Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord your God who teaches you to profit, who leads you in the way you should go. So this morning, before we introduce what we're going to learn, we're going to watch one word. 在今天早上啊，今天晚上北京时间，我们开始学习之前呢，我想给大家一起看一个这个单词啊，叫 the follower.中文现在很多人都翻译为粉丝啊。Look at the picture on the left side. 看一看左边有一张图片呢。So, 李佳琦 because one sentence he did something wrong and lost a lot of fans in the past. 这个中国比较有名的一个网红带货的啊，叫李佳琦，因为说出了一句话呀，这个一夜之间掉了很多的粉丝。So, a lot of followers.Of him, they decide to abandon him and go to somewhere else. 他的很多粉丝啊，因为他说了这句话呢，决定离开他而去了不同的地方。So we are the follower at will. 我们也是一个粉丝。我们是谁的粉丝呢？ So who is the follower? We are. So we are the follower of Jesus Christ. 我们是耶稣基督的跟随者，也是耶稣基督的粉丝啊。Last week we learned Genesis chapter 23, verse 1 through 20, a peace of mind, Sarah died. 上礼拜我们学习了创世纪的第23章1到20节，主题是一半馨香，莎拉死掉了。So today we are going to continue to learn Genesis chapter 24, verse 1 through 67. The title is Into...The unknown, follow the will of God. 今天我们准备接着学习创世纪，学习创世纪的第24章1到67节，主题是踏入未知，跟从上帝的意愿。So let's give a prayer in silence for the confession we did in the past weeks. 为我们过去一周呢所做的错事呢来进行忏悔，在静默中呢我们向上帝进行祷告。For 1 or 2 minutes, keep our heart quiet and pray to God and ask His mercy and ask His Spirit to lead with us for today's start at will. 在这个接下来一到两分钟时间呢，大家把这个心安静下来。让我们在静默中呢在这个向上帝祷告，为我们过去一周所做的错事呢来进行忏悔祷告，希望呢他的圣灵呢也带领我们今天的学习。Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Please have mercy on us. We are weak. We are human beings. We always make mistakes. And we, like the sheep, are astray from you. And please lead us back to your home and forgive us. Please let your spirit lead us for today's study at will. We are eager to hear from you. Please give us the strength and bless all the people who hear your words today online.And bless the people who cannot join our service today at will. We ask this in your son Jesus' name. Amen. So today's scripture reading comes from 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7 through 9. 今天的这个经文阅读呢，来自于彼得前书的第四章七到九节。So let Teresa to follow me to read this verse. 让那个 Teresa 来跟我一起来读一下。这两节经文，这三节经文。The end of all things is at hand.
All things is at hand.
Is at hand.
Is at hand.
Therefore, be self-controlled.
Self-controlled.
Be self-controlled.
Be self-controlled.
And sober-minded.
Sober-minded.
For the sake of your prayers.
For the sake of your
prayers.
Above all,
keep loving one another. Earnestly.
Since.
Love.
Covers.
A multitude. Of sins. Show. Hospitality.
Hospitality.
To one another. Without grumbling. Grumbling. Thank you. 彼得前书的第四章七到九节告诉我们，万物的结局近了，所以怎么样呢？我们要谨慎自守，警醒祷告。最要紧的呢是彼此相爱，因为爱呢能遮挡很多罪。 我们要互相款待，不发怨言。其实在生活中我们非常容易的去批评对方，看到别人的问题，很少看到自己的问题。而且呢，更多的时候呢，我们不愿去原谅别人，因为我们看到都是对方的缺点。在这里呢，彼得前书说呀，万物的结局近了，我们要用爱来去遮盖许多的罪，让我们能够相互款待，不发怨言。 In reality, most of the time we like criticize someone and we cannot forgive someone because it's so many hatred in the world. But here, Peter told us, the end of all things is at hand. So let us love one another because a multitude of sins could be covered by love.Show hospitality to one another without grumbling. 接下来的话呢，请大家把这个圣经打开啊。如果你有这个英文版的圣经的话呢，可以一边看一边读，一边看一边听啊。以前我总是说你这个听的时候不要看，这次为什么让你们一边听一边看呢？因为今天这个经文呢比较长，总共是有这个11分钟半，对，12分钟了。这么长的一段经文呢，你很难会记起来的很多的单词啊，特别是有些单词你并不是能够很熟悉。如果你有 ESV 版本的英文圣经呢，请你把这个圣经打开，然后接下来呢，我来放这个音频，你看一看它里面的有些生词是怎么发音的。或者说的，如果你的英语程度比较好呢，你也可以不用看这个圣经啊，你来去听就可以了。 So now please turn on, open your Bible. If you have ESV English BiblePlease listen the audio and read together because today is so many verses. You're not able to memorize and recognize the words because some words maybe never going to understand because it's too difficult. So if you have English ESV Bible, please open the Bible and ready to listen the audio and to see which word and how to pronounce.
Genesis 24. Now Abraham was old, well advanced in years, and the Lord had blessed Abraham in all things. And Abraham said to his servant, the oldest of his household, who had charge of all that he had,
Put your hand under my thigh, that I may make you swear by the Lord.The God of heaven and God of the earth, that you will not take a wife for my son, the daughters of the Canaanites among whom I dwell, but will go to my country and to my kindred and take a wife for my son Isaac.
The servant said to him,
Perhaps the woman may not be willing to follow me to this land. Must I then take your son back to the land from which you came?
Abraham said to him,
See to it that you do not take my son back there. The Lord, the God of heaven, who took me from my father's house and from the land of my kindred, and who spoke to me,And swore to me, to your offspring I will give this land. He will send his angel before you, and you shall take a wife for my son from there. But if the woman is not willing to follow you, then you will be free from this oath of mine.Only you must not take my son back there.
So the servant put his hand under the thigh of Abraham, his master, and swore to him concerning this matter. Then the servant took 10 of his master's camels and departed, taking all sorts of choice gifts from his master. And he arose and went to Mesopotamia, to the city of Nahor.And he made the camels kneel down outside the city by the well of water at the time of evening, the time when women go out to draw water. And he said,
O Lord God of my master Abraham, please grant me success today and show steadfast love to my master Abraham. Behold, I am standing by the spring of water, and the daughters of the men of the city are coming out to draw water. Let the young woman to whom I shall say, please let down your jar that I may drink, and who shall say, drink and I will water your camels, let her be the one whom you have appointed for your servant Isaac. By this I shall know that you have shown steadfast love to my master.
Before he had finished speaking, behold, Rebekah, who was born to Bethuel, the son of Milcah, the wife of Nahor, Abraham's brother, came out with her water jar on her shoulder. The young woman was very attractive in appearance, a maiden whom no man had known. She went down to the spring and filled her jar and came up. Then the servant ran to meet her and said,
please give me a little water to drink from your jar.
She said,
drink, my lord.
And she quickly let down her jar upon her hand and gave him a drink. When she had finished giving him a drink, she said,
I will draw water for your camels also until they have finished drinking.
So she quickly emptied her jar into the trough and ran again to the well to draw water, and she drew for all his camels. The man gazed at her in silence to learn whether the Lord had prospered his journey or not. When the camels had finished drinking, the man took a gold ring weighing a half shekel and two bracelets for her arms weighing 10 gold shekels, and said,
please tell me whose daughter you are. Is there room in your father's house for us to spend the night?
She said to him,
I am the daughter of Bethuel, the son of Milcah, whom she bore to Nahor.
She added,
we have plenty of both straw and fodder, and room to spend the night.
The man bowed his head and worshipped the Lord and said,
blessed be the Lord, the God of my master Abraham, who has not forsaken his steadfast love and his faithfulness toward my master. As for me, the Lord has led me in the way to the house of my master's kinsman.
Then the young woman ran and told her mother's household about these things. Rebekah had a brother whose name was Laban. Laban ran out toward the man to the spring. As soon as he saw the ring and the bracelets on his sister's arms and heard the words of Rebekah, his sister, thus the man spoke to me, he went to the man, and behold, he was standing by the camels at the spring. He said,
come in, O blessed of the Lord. Why do you stand outside? For I have prepared the house and a place for the camels.
So the man came to the house and unharnessed the camels and gave straw and fodder to the camels, and there was water to wash his feet and the feet of the men who were with him. Then food was set before him to eat, but he said,
I will not eat until I have said what I have to say.
He said,
speak on.
So he said,
I am Abraham's servant. The Lord has greatly blessed my master, and he has become great. He's given him flocks and herds, silver and gold, male servants and female servants, camels and donkeys. And Sarah, my master's wife, bore a son to my master when she was old, and to him he has given all that he has. My master made me swear, saying, you shall not take a wife for my son from the daughters of the Canaanites in whose land I dwell, but you shall go to my father's house and to my clan and take a wife for my son. I said to my master, perhaps the woman will not follow me. But he said to me, the Lord before whom I have walked will send his angel with you and prosper your way. You shall take a wife for my son from my clan and from my father's house. Then you will be free from my oath when you come to my clan. And if they will not give her to you, you will be free from my oath. I came today to the spring and said, O Lord, the God of my master Abraham, if now you are prospering the way that I go, behold, I'm standing by the spring of water. Let the virgin who comes out to draw water, to whom I shall say, please give me a little water from your jar to drink, and who will say to me, Drink, and I will draw for your camels also. Let her be the woman whom the Lord has appointed for my master's son. Before I had finished speaking in my heart, behold, Rebekah came out with her water jar on her shoulder, and she went down to the spring and drew water. I said to her, "Please let me drink." She quickly let down her jar from her shoulder and said, "Drink, and I will give your camels drink also." So I drank, and she gave the camels drink also. Then I asked her, "Whose daughter are you?" She said, "The daughter of Bethuel, Nahor's son, whom Milcah bore to him." So I put the ring on her nose and the bracelets on her arms. Then I bowed my head and worshipped the Lord and blessed the Lord, the God of my master Abraham, who had led me by the right way to take the daughter of my master's kinsman for his son. Now then, if you're going to show steadfast love and faithfulness to my master, tell me, and if not, tell me, that I may turn to the right hand or to the left.
Then Laban and Bethuel answered and said,
"The thing has come from the Lord. We cannot speak to you bad or good.
Behold, Rebekah is before you. Take her and go, and let her be the wife of your master's son, as the Lord has spoken."
When Abraham's servant heard their words, he bowed himself to the earth before the Lord. And the servant brought out jewelry of silver and of gold, and garments, and gave them to Rebekah. He also gave to her brother and to her mother costly ornaments. And he and the men who were with him ate and drank, and they spent the night there. When they arose in the morning, he said,
"Send me away to my master."
Her brother and her mother said,
"Let the young woman remain with us a while, at least 10 days. After that, she may go."
But he said to them,
"Do not delay me, since the Lord has prospered my way. Send me away, that I may go to my master."
They said,
"Let us call the young woman and ask her."
And they called Rebekah and said to her,
"Will you go with this man?"
She said,
"I will go."
So they sent away Rebekah, their sister, and her nurse, and Abraham's servant and his men. And they blessed Rebekah and said to her,
"Our sister, may you become thousands of 10,000s, and may your offspring possess the gate of those who hate him."
Then Rebekah and her young women arose and rode on the camels and followed the man. Thus the servant took Rebekah and went his way. Now Isaac had returned from Beer Lahairoi and was dwelling in the Negev. And Isaac went out to meditate in the field toward evening. And he lifted up his eyes and saw, and behold, there were camels coming. And Rebekah lifted up her eyes. And when she saw Isaac, she dismounted from the camel and said to the servant,
"Who is that man walking in the field to meet us?"
The servant said,
"It is my master."
So she took her veil and covered herself. And the servant told Isaac all the things that he had done. Then Isaac brought her into the tent of Sarah, his mother, and took Rebekah, and she became his wife, and he loved her. So Isaac was comforted after his mother's death.
So there is this very long passage for these chapters, and it took more than 10 minutes to listen all of that. 那这是一个非常长的一段经文啊，总共花费了是11分32秒钟的时间。 There's a lot of points we can learn from this passage, but we only want one point today. 在这一段经文里面呢，我们可以学习很多不同的观点。今天呢，我们只是学习其中一个观点。So first, let me read this Genesis chapter 24, verse 58. 首先让我来去读一下这一节经文。 And they called Rebekah and said to her, "Will you go with this man?" She said, "I will go." 那她的家人呢就叫了利百加来，问她说，你和这人同去吗？利百加说，我去。So my brothers and sisters, upon you read the story about Rebecca and Isaac, if you realize Rebecca only knows the servant maybe only 12 hours, she met him in the evening, and in the morning, the man wanted to take her away. And Rebecca's family is shepherd, and is far away from Isaac. So what's going on here? Why she decided to follow him? 啊，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，如果你要去读了这一段经文呢，《创世纪》第24章以撒和利百加的故事呢，你就知道哈，利百加在前一天晚上啊，刚刚遇到了这样一个仆人，他在井边啊打水的时候，这仆人见到他，然后请他到家里去住。那么第二天早上啊，这个仆人说要把他带走，而且呢带很远的一个地方。利百加的家里面呢，他们是放羊的啊，他们不是养骆驼的。他要跟着一个自己刚刚认识了12个小时左右的一晚上的一个仆人，要远嫁到另外一个地方啊，很远一个地方，还要去放骆驼啊，不是放羊。他为什么会这样说呢？为什么他会说我愿意去呢？他好像都没有问什么原因啊。当他家里人问说你和这人要同去吗？啊，他就说我去。 It sounds familiar, right? 这似乎有没有一个很类似或者熟悉的感觉呢？ Genesis chapter 12 verse 1 and verse 4, 我们再看一下创世纪的第12章第一节和第四节。 Now the Lord said to Abram, Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. So Abram went, as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he departed from Haran. 创世纪第十二章第一节第四节，耶和华对亚伯兰说，你要离开本地本族父家，往我所要指示你的地去。亚伯兰就照着耶和华的吩咐去了，罗德也和他同去。亚伯兰出哈兰的时候年75岁。所以当亚伯兰75岁的时候，他听到了上帝的呼召要去他指示的地方，他并不清楚上帝要给他指示的地方具体在哪里，在那里会发生什么样的事情。当他听到的呼召之后呢，他二话不说也没有迟疑，然后他就去了。这和 Rebecca 差不多， Rebecca 他听见了这个仆人说让他去远嫁到另外一个地方，他也没有迟疑，就说我愿意去。 So when Abraham later on we know his name changed to Abraham heard the call from the Lord, go to the land that he will show him, Abraham went, did not get any hesitation or ask any reason, same like Rebecca. That's another event occurred in the Bible as well. 另外在圣经里还有几个故事啊，给大家一起分享一下。So first, like Exodus chapter 3, verse 1 and verse 4. Now, Moses was keeping the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian, and he led his flock to the west side of the wilderness and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. When the Lord saw that, he turned aside to see. God called to him out of the bush, Moses, Moses, and he said, Here I am. 摩西牧养他岳父米甸祭司耶特罗的羊群啊，一日领羊群往野外去，到了上帝的山，就是何烈山。耶和华上帝见他过去要看，就从荆棘里呼叫说：“摩西，摩西！”他说：“我在这里。”这是 When Moses heard God called him, and he answered, "Here I am." 当摩西听到上帝呼叫他的时候，他回答上帝的话语说：“ 我在这里。 This is another from New Testament, Matthew chapter 4, verse 18 through 22. Let someone follow me to read these verses. 我们请一位来跟我读一下 马太福音的第4章18到22节的经文, 有类似的一个情况发生了。
Peter and Ray, 谢谢。
Well, walking by the Sea of Galilee.
Walking by the Sea of Galilee.
He saw two brothers.
He saw two brothers.
Simon. Who is called Peter.
Who is called Peter.
And Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea,
for they were fishermen,
and he said to them. Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Immediately they left their nets, and followed him. And going on from there, he saw two other brothers. James, the son of Zebedee.
And John, his brother.
In the boat with Zebedee, their father. Mending their net.
And he caught them.
Immediately,
they left the boat.
And their father. And followed him. Thank you. 马太福音第4章18到22节, 当耶稣在加利利海边行走, 看见兄弟二人, 就是那称呼彼得的西门和他的兄弟安德烈, 在海里撒网, 他们本是打鱼的, 耶稣对他们说, 来跟从我, 我要叫你们得人如得鱼一样, 他们就立刻舍了网, 跟从了他, 从那里往前走, 又看见兄弟二人, 就是西比泰的儿子雅各, 和他的兄弟约翰, 从他的父亲西比泰在船上捕网, 耶稣就招呼他们, 他们立刻舍了船, 别了父亲, 跟从了耶稣。 Matthew chapter 26, verse 36 and 39. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here, while I go over there and pray." And going a little farther, he fell on his face and prayed, saying, "My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." 耶稣同门徒来到一个地方, 名叫克西马尼, 就对他们说, 你们坐在这里, 等我到那边去祷告。 他就稍往前走, 伏在地, 祷告说, 我父啊, 倘若可行, 求你叫这杯离开我, 然而, 不要照我的意思，只要照你的意思。So my brothers and sisters, today, Jesus is calling you to follow him. 啊，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，今天耶稣也呼召你来跟从他。Are you ready to follow him? 你有没有准备好来跟从他？ Rebecca 刚刚认识这样一个仆人十二个小时，他就决定跟从这个仆人去远嫁给以撒。彼得和西门看见耶稣，耶稣呼召他们，他们马上把网丢下来跟着他了。约翰和安德烈也是一样，当耶稣呼召他们的时候，他们就离开他的父亲去跟从了耶稣。当耶稣要去上十字架之前那天晚上祷告的时候，虽然他是非常的痛苦，不但是要痛苦于离开他的门徒们，还要痛苦于上十字架这个所有的受苦，他当时向上帝祷告说，如果可能的话，可不可以不要去这样做，但是耶稣祷告说，不是按照我的意思，却是按照你的意思。虽然明天面对着十字架的羞辱、痛苦和别离，耶稣还是决定要跟随上帝的意愿。在今天，无论你是处在一个什么的境地，或者你在面临着一个什么情况，当耶稣呼召你去跟从他，成为基督徒的时候，你有没有像我们刚才讲的这些人一样，丢下你所留恋的，跟从了耶稣基督呢？So before we really dig into today's passage, let's listen to this song first. 在我们具体讲今天所学习的创世纪的第24章的一些具体经文之前呢，让我们一起来听一首歌曲啊。The song's name is I Will Follow. 啊，这个歌曲的名字是说我会跟随。
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow. All your ways are good. All your ways are sure. I will trust in you.Above my life, I will trust in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Who you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve.If this life I lose, I will follow.
You must wonder, if I decide to follow Jesus today, is I'm ready for that? 你可能会说，今天我已经准备好了要去跟从耶稣基督了吗？耶稣今天呼召我去跟从他，我准备好了吗？ So let's look at God's preparations. 咱们来看看上帝的预备。From the story, how God prepared for Rebecca. 我们来从上帝为利百加所预备的过程来回顾一下自己上帝对你的预备。我们先来看一下上帝对利百加的一个预备。我们准备从六点来去学习。So we're going to learn from six different outlines how God prepared for Rebecca.Number one, a shared faith with Isaac. Number two, purity. Number three, an excellent wife character. Number four, sure hospitality. Number five, fears the Lord. Number six, a willingness to follow. So let's learn number one, a shared faith with Isaac. 首先我们先看第一点啊，这个Rebecca 和 Isaac 一个共通点就是有一个共同的信仰 A shared faith with Isaac Genesis chapter 11 verse 27 Now, these are the generations of Terah Terah fathered Abram, Nahor, and Haran And Haran fathered Lot 在创世纪的第11章27节我们知道塔拉生了三个孩子亚伯拉罕和拿赫还有哈兰哈兰当时就死掉了就剩亚伯拉罕和拿赫也就是说亚伯拉罕和拿赫他们是兄弟两个那拿赫又生了谁呢 Genesis chapter 22 verse 20 22 and 23 Now after these things it was told to Abraham Behold Milcah alsohas born children to your brother Nahor, Chesed, Hazor, Pardash, Jadalash, and Bethro. Bethro fathered Rebekah. These eight Milcah bore to Nahor, Abraham's brother. 在这事以后就是当亚伯拉罕这个经历了各种事情以后有人就跟亚伯拉罕说的密加给你兄弟拿赫生了几个儿子。也就是说亚伯拉罕的兄弟啊生了这几个孩子其中这个孩子之一呢叫比士利比士利呢就是利百加的父亲啊所以说利百加是出生在亚伯拉罕兄弟的家庭里面而且是他兄弟的一个孙女 Genesis chapter 24 verse 15 Before he had finished speaking Behold Rebecca who was born to Bethro, the son of Milcah, the wife of Nahor, Abraham's brother, came out with her water jar on her shoulder. 就话还没说完呢，不料利百加肩头上扛着水瓶出来。利百加是波士利所生的，波士利是亚伯拉罕兄弟拿赫妻子密加的儿子，所以说也就是这个利百加呀，是亚伯拉罕兄弟的孙女。So from Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 through 3, Now the Lord said to Abram, Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you, and I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you I will curse. And in you all the families of earth shall be blessed. 创世纪第十二章一到三节，耶和华对亚伯兰说，你要离开本地本族父家，往我要所要指示你的地去，我必使你成为大国，我必赐福给你，使你的名为大。你要使别人得福，为你祝福的我必赐福给他，诅咒你的我必诅咒他，地上万族都必因你得福。 So from here we saw God promised Abraham, and this word must be spread around the generation, every different peoples of there. 那在这里呢，我们看到上帝跟亚伯拉罕的呼召呢，我相信这个故事啊，亚伯拉罕呢也当时叫亚伯兰呢，应该给他家里面的很多人都已经讲过了。那在这个时候呢，我相信这个亚伯拉罕的兄弟拿赫也听说了这个故事。我们从刚才的经文中也知道呢，上帝不但保守了亚伯拉罕他一家的一切的行为行在他的旨意之上，而且呢他也保守了拿赫生养众多，生了好几个孩子，其中一个孩子呢生了这个利百加，这是我们刚才学的一个经文。那么在这个Genesis chapter 24 verse 60, we learned this one sentence to confirm what I said just now. 在这个创世纪的第24章第60节有一节经文呢，在也验证了我刚才所说的，他兄弟也知道上帝对他的祝福。他是怎么说的呢？ And they blessed Rebecca and said to her, Our sister, may you become thousands of 10,000.And may your offspring possess the gate of those who hate him. 在创世纪第24章60节，利百加的家里人给他说了这一句话，说我的妹子，愿你做千万人的母，愿你的后裔得着仇敌的城门。这就说明他们知道上帝对亚伯拉罕的一个应许。So number two, the preparation is purity. 第二点呢，就是这个纯洁。Genesis chapter 24, verse 16. The young woman was very attractive in appearance, a maiden who no man had known. She went down to the spring and filled her jar and came up. 那女子容貌极其俊美，还是处女，也未曾有人亲近她。她下到井旁，打满了瓶，又上来。所以在这节经文，我们看到利百加当时是一个纯洁的少女。I think you must learn something like we are the bride of Jesus Christ and the church is the bride of Jesus Christ. We should purify ourselves and prepare for the marriage. 我相信你们也听说过啊，这个教会啊，就是耶稣基督的新娘，我们一定要纯洁自己，预备将来呢能够嫁给耶稣啊。这个以后我们会再讲。So we're going to learn this next, in the future, but not today. 今天我们就不再讲。But it's very important to stay.Purity, 非常重要的，你要使自己保持纯洁。Number three, an excellent wife character, 第三点呢，就是上帝给利百加所准备的是一个贤德妇人的品格。Proverbs chapter 31, verse 1 through 31st, there's a lot of character list from there. 在箴言的31章1到31节呀，列举了很多贤德妇人应该有的一些品格，我这里呢就选了两节经文给大家分享一下。 So I'm going to choose two words from there to share with you, verse 17 and verse 20. She dresses herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hand to the needy.他以能力束腰，使臂膀有力。他张手周济困苦人，伸手帮补穷乏人。那利百加是怎么样的呢？我们看到 Genesis chapter 24 verse 15, Rebecca came out with her water jar on her shoulder. 那说明她的臂膀是非常有力的，扛着这个水瓶出来的。So,Let someone follow me to read Genesis chapter 24, verse 17 through 20. 请一位来跟我读一下 创世纪的第24章17到20节，看看利百加是不是像刚才我们所描述的贤德妇人这一块，张手周济困苦人，伸手帮补穷乏人，他是不是显示了他这一种慷慨啊？请玉来跟我读一下这几节经文。
601谢谢。
Then
the servant ran to meet her and said, please give me a little water to drink from your jar.
Please give me a little water to drink from your jar.
She said, Drink, my lord. And she quickly let down her jar.
Upon her hand.
And gave him a drink.
He said,
I will draw water for your camels also.
I will draw water for your clams also.
Camels also. Until they have finished drinking. So, she quickly emptied her jar. Into the sour. And ran again. To the well. To draw water. And she drew for all his camels. All right, thank you. 我们看一下利百加的有力啊，臂膀扛了这个水罐，同时他热情的好客是什么一个程度啊？当这个一个陌生人在井边带了十头骆驼，向他要一点水的时候啊，他毫不迟疑的把这个水罐从肩上拿下来，拿在手上端给他说：“请喝吧，我不但让你喝呀，我还要喂饱了你十头骆驼。”当他喝完之后，他马上跑到井边，再喂了十头骆驼的水呀。想象一下这样一个场景，想象他做了多少的工作，你就知道利百加他是符合贤德妇人的这么一个标准的。So number four, show hospitality 啊，第四点呢就是展示他的慷慨好客。First Peter chapter 4 verse 7 through 9, as we learned earlier, 像今天我们前面读的彼得前书第四章七到九节。The end of all things is at hand. Therefore, be self-controlled and sober-minded for the sake of your prayers. Above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers a multitude of sins. Show hospitality to one another without grumbling. 万物的结局近了，所以你们要谨慎自守，警醒祷告。最要紧的是彼此相爱，因为爱可以遮掩许多罪。你们要互相款待，不发怨言。Genesis chapter 24, verse 23 through 25， 在创世纪的第24章23到25节，我们看一看 Rebecca 是那个怎么来去对待别人的哈。And said, please tell me, whose daughter you are? Is there room in the father's house for us to spend the night? She said to him.I'm the daughter of Bethuel, the son of Micah, whom he brought to Nahor. And she added, we have plenty of both straw and fodders, and room to spend the night. 创世纪第24章23到25节，那个仆人问 约巴卡说，请告诉我你是谁的女儿啊，你父亲家里有没有我们住的地方啊？那约巴卡就回答，我是密加与拿赫之子比斯利的女儿。又说啊，补充说，我家里就足有粮草，也有住宿的地方啊，你来就可以了，没问题的啊。So number five, fears the Lord 啊，我怎么说他是敬畏上帝呢？我们看一下 Genesis chapter 24 verse 64 through 65. And Rebecca lifted up her eyes, and when she saw Isaac, she dismounted from the camel, and said to the servant, "Who is that man walking in the field to meet us?" The servant said, "It is my master." So she took her veil and covered herself. 所以当利百加举目看见以撒的时候，就赶紧下了骆驼，表示他很尊敬，问那仆人说，这天天走来迎接我们的是谁呢？啊，仆人说，是我的主人。利百加马上啊就拿这个帕子蒙上了脸。在过去的时候啊，当这些人去尊敬这个另外一个人的时候啊，不但对人显示尊敬，其实也显示了对神的一个尊敬啊，所以他是比较啊敬畏上帝的。Number six, a willingness to follow. 啊，第四点，第六点也是最后一点呢，就是你愿意跟从。我们前面读过啊 ，Genesis chapter 24 verse 58, and they called Rebecca and said to her, "Will you go with this man?" She said, "I will go." 啊，这家人问利百加说，你去不去啊？利百加说，我去。So today's conclusion is: trust in God's plan, obey, and have desire to fulfill His will. Trust in God's plan, obey, and have a desire to fulfill His will. 啊，今天的结论说要相信上帝的计划，顺服并情愿完成他的意志。Proverbs chapter 3 verse 3 and 6. Let not steadfast love and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the template of your heart. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your path. 不可使慈爱、诚实离开你，要系在你颈项上，刻在你心门上，在你一切所行的事上都要认定他，他必指引你的路。 Deuteronomy chapter 5 verse 33, You shall walk in all the ways that the Lord your God has commanded you, that you may live, and that may go well with you, and that you may live long in the land that you shall possess. 耶和华你们的上帝吩咐你们行的，你们都要去行，使你们可以存活得福，并使你们的日子在所要承受的地上得以长久。 So today's application we have six. 那今天我们today's application we have four. 那今天呢我们有四点的应用。 We're going to explain more tomorrow in Chinese. 啊，明天呢我们准备用中文讲的时候呢会具体来讲。 But we just go over these four points today. 今天我们只是过一遍这四点哈。 Number one, trust in God'sGuidance. Number two, character matters. Number three, faith in action. Number four, prayer and God's providence. 第一点呢，就是要相信上帝的引领。第二点呢，是品格很关键。第三点呢，是信心要体现在行为上。第四点呢，就是祷告和上帝的眷顾。So let's give a prayer for today's study. 啊，让我们为今天的学习来做个祷告。我们在天上的父，众人都尊你的名为圣，真的感谢你的大能，使我们在各种不同的情况下、不同的原因，还有时间，我们大家来到这个线上，通过这一种方式来敬拜你、学习你的话语。我们也替那些没能够参加我们今天敬拜的弟兄姐妹祷告，希望他能够在他们的时间里面啊，找出更加合适的时间参加我们的聚会。因为不可以去停止聚会，只有我们大家在一起相聚，才能够去一起显示出你的荣耀来。也求你保守我们的心，使我保守一切。亲爱的天父上帝，感谢你今天的带领，让我们知道我们要跟随你，让我们在你的在信心上更加的坚定。求你引领我们，也请你让我们有一颗纯洁的心，让我们能够来在你的面前。求你让我们彼此相爱，让我们不要彼此去，让我们彼此去造就。 求你带领我们啊，特别为我们每一个人今天来到你的面前的人啊，求你赐福给我们。以上祷告奉我主基督耶稣的名求，阿门。Okay, so may God bless you. See you tomorrow or next week. 愿上帝赐福给你。我们明天或者下礼拜再见。